Women in Britain are begging Islamic scholars to release them from unhappy, even violent marriages.
I felt I should be ashamed of being there, and that how dare I have the audacity to seek a divorce, and that I was bringing shame onto my culture.
These women are afraid to be identified for fear of their own community. Some have experienced domestic violence ignored by religious courts.
Even with the violence, they just totally disregarded me.
Tonight, Panorama goes undercover to investigate what's really happening in Britain's Sharia councils.
I am now really scared. I don't know whether you think I should tell the police, or anybody else.
Not the police.
And we find an Islamic judge telling a woman to ask the man abusing her if it's her fault.
Is it because of my cooking? Is it because I see my friends, So, I can correct myself.
Okay, how can Islamic Shria Council help you?
In this terraced house in East London, Islamic scholars grant divorces, Sharia style.
And one more question, sister.
Around 50 cases, mainly marital disputes, are heard at Leighton Sharia Council each month, 90% of them brought by women from all over the country. With an Islamic marriage, it's easier for a man to divorce. For many women in Britain, the only way is through these councils. This couple don't want to be identified.
There's, you know, so many things between him and me. He says something else, I say something else, then we are totally different, you know. We can't stand each other.
They've been coming here for a year. The wife wants a divorce, the husband is refusing. Their case is being heard by the most senior scholar, Dr. Suhaib Hassan.
But the main thing is, can we live together now because of this, all these disputes and... You are saying that he was abusing you verbally, huh?
Yeah.
No, never ever did that. Never ever accuse, abuse, or beat, or anything. Nothing.
That's you saying.
We have an argument.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. You didn't do it.
So that's not going to be resolved.
The wife says her husband refuses to work, fails to support her, and ignores the children.
You have three kids,
yes.
9 years, 8 years, 3 years. They need a father on the...
I'm not saying that they need a father, they see
but
him every
7 days. But if you are separated,
day.
Then what is going to happen? They can't see him regularly.
They see him every Saturday.
That is enough.
Only for 3 hours.
So you can have 6 hours? I don't mind. You can have 6 hours. When he was at home, how much time did you give them?
Yeah, all the time.
All the time sleeping, all the time drinking tea, all the time eating. Go to your room, don't make noise, I can't bear it. That was your time? You took them out anyway? No.
When Dr. Hassan sends the husband out, the wife breaks down and begs for a divorce.
She came to my place.
What's the point? When everything is finished, she's regretting. What's the point? I got nothing to do with him. I don't feel like anything for him.
I can't do it anymore. I hate him. मुझे इसकी शक्ल भी नहीं देखनी अच्छी लगती. He ruined my life. कभी सोया उठता था सारा कुछ. अभी हमने सारे गुनाह माफ करवा रहा है काम करके कि जी मैं काम कर रहा हूँ दुनिया को दिखा रहा है कि मैं जो कहती हूँ मैं कर रहा हूँ.
चले एक महीना और दे दें उसको.
प्लीज नहीं
देखें. नहीं एक महीना का मतलब ये कि आप भी दुआ करें अल्लाह से वो भी दुआ करें उसी में मैं कहूँगा कि जो अल्लाह ताला जो बेहतर हो वो अल्लाह ताला आपको मुकद्दर कर दे.
For this woman, a Sharia divorce is the only option because the couple only had a Sharia marriage, not a British civil one.
I have listened to her now. This is why I'm giving you this last just 1 month's time. Now you can leave, both of you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Another month. It's been a year already. And Leighton Sharia Council still isn't granting this woman a divorce. Leighton is one of Britain's oldest and most active Islamic councils. They cannot enforce their judgments, but places like this control the lives of many Muslim women in Britain today.
We try to facilitate for the Muslim community something which they badly need. Because there is no other institution which can provide such services. So we are providing it. We are not here just to issue divorces, but we want to mediate first. We try to save the marriages first. We don't want breakup of the marriages a lot. So when the people come to us, we try to reconcile them.
Yes, of course.
But Islamic rulings given here aren't always in the interests of the women concerned and can run counter to British law. I set off round the country to find out more about Britain's Sharia councils. At King's Cross Station, I met Baroness Cox. She's introduced a private members' bill in the House of Lords to make it an offence for Sharia councils to set themselves up as courts giving judgments. We were on our way to Leeds.
If one looks at the way in which this system of Sharia courts work and the way it's believed to work by people in those communities, it is actually operating like a parallel legal system in this country. And in a democracy, you can't have two legal systems. There has to be one law for all.
No one knows how many Sharia councils there are in Britain, in mosques and houses. One report estimates at least 85.
You know, it probably wouldn't be safe.
Baroness Cox has come to Leeds to visit Carmen of Honor, a charity which runs a helpline for victims of honour-based violence and forced marriage.
Mm-hmm. And with the domestic violence as well. And
a significant number of women who call complain about Sharia councils.
The provisions of many of the Sharia courts, which are so discriminatory, we've heard a lot of evidence of women who are really suffering as a result of the rulings of Sharia courts, of domestic violence being condoned, differential access to divorce, issues to do with the care of children, and it is essential that something is done about it.
Sharia councils say their main concern is saving marriages through reconciliation. But in Leeds, I met a woman who had to battle with Leighton Sharia Council for 10 years, long after her marriage had broken down and her husband was back in Pakistan.
Everybody around me told me that I still needed an Islamic divorce, and that's what I firmly believe in order to move on with my life.
Farah got a civil divorce from the British courts within 6 months, but Leighton had a different approach.
They did pressure me to go back to him, even though I'd shown him a civil divorce, that there's no going back from this because I haven't seen him. It must have been about 6 years at that point.
Not only did Leighton want Farah to go back to her husband, she was bringing up her young daughter alone. But she says they tried to interfere in child access, which they're not allowed to do.
They still wanted a condition where I would, upon my own expenses, take her back to Pakistan and allow him to see her. And I refused to do this. And they said, if you refuse to do this, then we can't help you. And I felt extremely frustrated at that point.
A barrister specializing in family law got involved in Farah's case. Charlotte Proudman has been to many hearings at Sharia councils and is worried about what she's seen.
They're totally unregulated, unauthorised, there's no accountability, and many of them are not operating in accordance with UK law. Unfortunately, they are ruling on contact matters, residence disputes, and they certainly don't act in accordance with UK law, where it's the paramount importance is the child's welfare.
Leighton says it doesn't get involved with children, but Sharia rulings on such matters have featured on their website. One Islamic school of thought decrees a father can take custody of a boy from the age of 7, a girl as young as 9. When Farah refused to agree to Leighton's demand to give her husband in Pakistan access rights, she says her divorce ground to a halt.
This is definitely what delayed it, because they did say point blank, well, we can't give you this then, because you must sign this.
They're not supposed to make rulings with regard to children. Did you know that?
I didn't know that at the time. And that's why I felt really powerless to do anything.
She was held to ransom. Unless she agreed to a husband having contact with her daughter, they wouldn't issue her with a Sharia divorce, which is why the whole process took some 10 years.
When Leighton finally agreed to issue a divorce certificate, Farah decided it wasn't worth pursuing anymore. We've heard of even more worrying divorce cases handled by Leighton Sharia Council, where children and domestic violence are involved. This woman told peers at the House of Lords about her application to Leighton for a Sharia divorce.
It was an ordeal in itself, a terrible experience.
Sonia had already been granted a divorce by a UK court because of her husband's extreme violence.
He started beating me up, pulling my hair, punching me, kicking me, and then eventually he took me down the stairs. I was unconscious for I don't know how long.
Sonia's husband hit their young son too, so the British court ruled he could only have indirect contact with their children. But Leighton Sharia Council told Sonia she'd have to give the children up to him.
I couldn't bear the thought of such a violent person having my children. So this came as a major shock to me. But what was even more shocking was when I explained this to them on the phone, why he shouldn't have the access to the children. Their reaction was, well, you can't go against what Islam says.
Sonia stood her ground. Eventually, she got Leighton Sharia Council to drop their demand she give up her children.
I knew that they couldn't rule over the Queen's law, so this is why this helped me majorly to win my battle with the Sharia eventually. Almost 2 years to get my divorce. Their attitude was absolutely diabolical.
When we asked Leighton Sharia Council about Sonia and Farah's cases, they told us that with regard to children, if a marriage ends, then the question of access to both parents is crucial. Safety is paramount, they say, and any UK court order must be followed.
In East London, we'd seen the public face of one of the country's main Sharia councils, serving the Muslim community. Leighton say they don't advise women who have been abused to return to their husbands. But given the experience of the two women we'd talked to, we wanted to see what advice Leighton would give a vulnerable female client. We sent an undercover reporter to consult Dr. Hassan. Her story, that her husband was hitting her, was based on ones we'd heard. The government says domestic violence is a crime which should be reported to the police.
Do you think I should tell anybody else, the police maybe? Do you think I should leave their home? Because I'm scared to be in the house with him.
And he actually hits you, huh?
He hits me. He does hit me.
So never at this time.
What do you mean to me?
No, it's leave some little on your body.
Now he's hitting me at times where it obviously hurts. Do you think I should go to the police? Do you think I should leave the house? What do you suggest?
He's starting to make it nasty, too. That is, he becomes so aggressive. Starts hitting you, punching you. And of course, you have to report to the police. That is not allowed.
Dr. Hassan sits on a dais above the woman, like in a court. He wonders if she's done anything to provoke this treatment.
Question, I think you should be courageous enough to ask this question to him, that describe me why you are upset, huh? Is it because of my cooking? Is it because I see my friends, huh? So, I can correct myself.
Dr. Hassan suggests the woman involves her mother and brings her husband here.
I agree with my opinion that we want this person to come here. This Islamic council come to us. If he did not come, then how can you correct himself? You will know the police if he hits you. But you must understand that this will be the final blow. You have to leave the house. Where will you go then? Refuse? Refuse means the state refuse.